In this video, we're going to take a closer look at kinematic equations. Let's investigate kinematic equations and how to solve problems involving one-dimensional motion with them. Our first problem involves the calculation of displacement while there is a constant acceleration. The problem states that a car accelerates uniformly from rest to a velocity of 7.1 meters per second in 8.1 seconds. Find the displacement of the car during this time. When solving kinematic equations, the first thing we always want to do is write down the variables that we're given, as well as what we're solving for. In this question, we're told that the car accelerates uniformly. This means the acceleration is constant, although we don't know its value from the information given. We can place that right here in our data table. We also know, since the question indicated that the car accelerated from rest, that the initial velocity is zero, so we can place that in our data table right here. The question asks us to solve for displacement, so we can write down a d with a question mark here, since we know that's the variable we're solving for. We know the final velocity is 7.1 meters per second, so we can plug that in for final velocity right here. We also know that the time elapsed was 8.1 meters per second, so we can plug that in for t right here. Next, we want to consult the kinematic equations and determine which equation we should use to solve the problem based on the variables that we are given. Since we need to solve for displacement, and the only variables we've been given are initial and final velocities, along with the time elapsed, the equation we should use would be displacement equals 1/2 initial velocity plus final velocity times time. So when we plug in those values and take 7.1 meters per second plus zero, then multiply that times 1/2 times the time, which was 8.1 seconds, we find our answer to be 28.755. But if we would round that to two significant figures, that is 29 meters. So the displacement of the car was 29 meters. Our next problem involves a kinematic calculation involving velocity and displacement, while there is a constant acceleration. A car with an initial velocity of 5.15 meters per second accelerates uniformly at a rate of 2.75 meters per second squared. Find the final velocity and the displacement after 8.00 seconds. As always, the first thing we want to do is set up a data table with all of our variables. The time was given to us at 8.00 seconds, so let's write that down here. The initial velocity was given to us at 5.15 meters per second, so let's write that down here. The acceleration was constant, and it was given. Its value was 2.75 meters per second squared, so let's write that down here. We need to solve for final velocity as well as displacement. When we look at the kinematic equations that we have available to us, you may notice that if we use the equation final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration times time, that we have enough information, so we can solve for final velocity with that equation. So let's do that first. Let's plug in 5.15 meters per second for initial velocity, and we will add that to the product of the acceleration, which is 2.75 meters per second squared, times the time, which is 8.00 seconds. When we solve for final velocity, we find that the car was traveling 27.2 meters per second after 8.00 seconds have elapsed. To solve for displacement, we can now use the equation that we used in the first problem. Displacement equals 1/2 of the product of the sum of the initial and final velocities times the time. So if we take 1/2 of the sum of 5.15 meters per second and 27.2 meters per second, we get 16.2 meters per second, and then if we multiply that times the time elapsed, which was 8.00 seconds, we get 129. So the displacement was 129 meters for this car. Now here's one for you to try. A car is traveling at 7.0 meters per second and accelerates at a constant rate of 2.5 meters per second squared to reach a velocity of 12.0 meters per second. How long does it take for the car to reach its final velocity? Go ahead, press pause, give it a try, and when you think you have the answer, come back and check your work. Did you get 2.0 seconds? If so, great job. If not, let's take a look at the solution together. The first thing we wanted to do was create a data table with the variables that we were given, as well as what we were solving for. We knew that the car was traveling at 7.0 meters per second. That was its initial velocity. We also know from the problem that the acceleration was constant, and it was 2.5 meters per second squared. The question also tells us that the final velocity was 12.0 meters per second. We needed to solve for the time. So now that we know we need to solve for time, and we were given both initial and final velocity, as well as acceleration, the kinematic equation to use would be final velocity is equal to the initial velocity plus the product of the acceleration and time. If we rearrange that equation for time by first subtracting both sides of the equation by the initial velocity, then dividing both sides of the equation by the acceleration, we will have the time isolated on one side of the equation. Now we can plug in our values and find the difference in final velocity and initial velocity, which would be 12.0 meters per second minus 7.0 meters per second, which is 5.0 meters per second. Then we can divide that by the acceleration, which is 2.5 meters per second squared, and we are left with the time 2.0 seconds. That's a closer look at kinematic equations. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage where the entire series is available to you.